Services Business AM. We are at the last part of our show this morning, and that means that we're going to tell you exactly what is trending in different sectors and industries in the economy. Now, if you're aware, on 8th of March 2020, it's International Women's Day. So from Business AM Fraternity, it is a happy Women's Day in advance for all of us here in the studio, which therefore means that it makes sense, therefore, because today is on Friday and we won't really have a chance, therefore, on Sunday to give you the stories of women around the world and also in Kenya to give you examples of women who have identified areas within the Kenyan economy to set the standards and also prosper in that as well. This morning, we are talking about the fashion industry, which we do know is dominated by women and women brands. We are privileged to host one of those brands here on Business AM today. We have Africaserie, all right? And we don't have the founder in the studio this morning. Marina Keseri starts from there. Marin, nimepata jina vizuri?
Yes.
Is it Marin ama Marin?
Marin.
Marin.
Yes.
Ah, fantastic. Thank you very much for joining us in the studio this morning. Isn't it? Good. We're going to look at the models that you have here, and then we have an example of exactly who and how we're going to talk about this. But can you talk to me? Africaserie. I know it has your name in it.
Yeah.
When did you found this company? What was the idea behind it?
Okay, Africaserie. When I studied fashion, I didn't know, I didn't have a name for the company.
Yes.
So I won an award in 2017.
Yes.
Then
which award was this?
I won Female Designer of the Year.
Oh, fantastic. At House of Legacy.
Thank you so much. So when I won the first award,
yes.
On the certificate it was written Keseri Dera. Yes.
Is like an individual, not a company.
Yes, because
yes.
Yeah. So I didn't have a company. I didn't know it would be a company.
Yes.
I didn't know it would be a business.
Mm-hmm.
So when I went for the second, when I was nominated again the
yes.
second time, it took me 6 months to come up with a name.
Yes.
Yeah. So I thought maybe because I deal with Ankara pieces mostly, and my name is unique. So I said I would say Afri for African, and then Keseri for my name. And then I said, because I want it to be a bit unique, I did not use the C, and I said collections, because I did with a variety of pieces. I did with shoes,
yes.
I did with bags, I did with head wraps, fabrics, outfits, and all that. So I said Africaserie collections would be perfect.
Pretty much, isn't it? Quite a wonderful story behind the company as well.
Thank you.
Talk to me about this. Is it Ankara space? I know some people call it Ankara, I call it Ankara, the way it is. What opportunity does it have, and why did you therefore decide to say, I'm going into this space for Ankara?
Okay, when I was growing up, there was so much Ankara or Kitenge or African pieces.
Yes.
But it got to a time when I thought they'd lost their taste, because you'd hear bad you know, bad feedback.
Yes.
Oh, you're in Kenya uniform, I can't wear Kenya uniform, because people used to get same fabrics.
Mm-hmm.
And then we used to make the same designs.
Yes.
So I when I came in, I knew I would make pieces that are unique.
Mm-hmm.
And not only women and older women can say, yeah, older women and married women can put on Ankara pieces.
Yes.
Because The western part of Africa, people use, or rather women use Ankara pieces, older women, there's no young girls who used to use, to wear them. So I thought, how about I just, as a young person,
mm-hmm.
I just try and revive the taste and the fashion and the authenticity of the fabric.
Yes.
In a way that anyone can wear, from babies to young women to
yes.
older women. So I tried to get pieces and patterns that could fit anybody.
Pretty much, isn't it?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So when I started, I thought maybe I should get some designs that would fit ladies.
Yes.
And then women, and then older women, you know. So I think that is how it worked for me, because a lot of people had lost trust in it, because everyone said it's Kenya uniform.
And that's a term that we're going to define shortly. So I want us to throw our eyes to your morals in the studio this morning. Therefore, I want you to describe for me what they have on, what is the idea behind it, and which places they can go when they're dressed like this. So we start to understand just the whole idea behind Ankara itself.
Okay, so this is Mwanam Kasi.
Yes.
She's wearing an orange, and the pattern is a bold pattern. The pattern of a fabric is a bold pattern.
Yes.
And also there's an orange in it. So this means that anybody can wear the... There's people who fear colors, and it has a touch of yellow if you look at it closely. There's people who are like, I can't wear a fabric that is too bright, and I can't wear a fabric because of my color, because of my personality and all that. But this is a piece that anyone can wear. You can go with this, let me begin, to church.
Yes.
You can go with it for a meeting.
Yes.
You can go with this to work because
yes.
it's very decent. It's just like a kimono, and then she's wearing some leggings inside. So you can wear it, without leggings or with leggings.
Yes.
Then her head wrap is, easy, like a day-to-day wrap.
Yes.
You can go with it, on an outing, meeting your girls, for an office. You can wear that head wrap.
Yes.
So basically, this is an all-round, you can wear it anytime, any day, anywhere.
Yes.
That's very comfortable.
Pretty much, isn't it?
Yeah.
So I just want us to move to the next model, therefore. And can you describe for me, can I preempt?
Yeah.
She looks like an African comfortable woman, like the sort of woman that we want to celebrate on Sunday. Is that what we have there?
When I made the outfit, when I wore it the first time, I made another thing. It's an idea that I have never, I have never made. So I made the first piece for myself.
Yes.
Then someone said, "Unaka bibia pasta." So, and I actually found out that a lot of people loved it.
Yes.
So I thought maybe I should make more pieces, and that's how I came up with that. Because if you look at her, a Muslim lady can wear it because it covers her lower part.
Yes.
So a Muslim lady can wear it.
Yes.
A woman in church can wear it.
Yes.
This, you can go, it's very decent. Atani kiambiwa, twende rurashio.
Ah, fantastic, isn't it?
It's very decent.
It is very decent,
yes.
Isn't it? I'm going to come to you because you have to also describe yourself exactly what it is. But let's talk about what really stands out when you're dressing out Ankara. All of them have head wraps. Is it something that has to go with it? Or you can do Ankara without a head wrap?
Depending on your personality and what you like. There's people who are like, I cannot wear a head wrap.
Yes.
It's too much.
Yes.
But because there's a campaign I'm doing for women with cancer. You know, when they start the chemotherapy, their hair falls off.
Yes.
Yeah, so there's something I'm doing with them. So I donate head wraps for them. And then we have sessions where I teach them how to do it. And that... it's something that I've been doing for some time.
Yes.
So let's get back to the head wrap.
Mm-hmm.
For Ankaras, it's not a must you have a head wrap on. You can rock it with hair.
Yes.
You can rock it with short hair. You can rock it with anything. You can rock it with a head wrap that's similar to the fabric.
Yes.
Or a head wrap that's not similar, like the case that we have here.
Yes.
Even on me, the head wrap is not the same like the outfit I'm wearing.
So it really doesn't have too much
it
in terms of color,
to.
Isn't it?
It doesn't have to.
Yes.
Because even me, the pink is not, this is another color.
Yes.
Whatever I'm wearing is another color.
Yes.
Yes.
I'm going to talk to you about your models again. I just want to therefore focus on you therefore. Since we're celebrating again women on Sunday as well, by the way. How did you first get your finances for your Africa Sebi now? Let's go back there therefore.
That was back in, I was very young. 2015.
Yes.
I was in campus.
Yes.
And my dad apparently hadn't sent me money for some time. So I called, "Hey dad, I need money." Do you know what he asked me? "Do you think if I had the money, I would not send you?" Then I knew, boom.
There's no money.
There's no money. I need to just find a way to have money.
Yes.
I'm in campus, I'm in Nairobi.
Yes.
I hadn't even stayed a year in Nairobi because I had joined campus 2014 there.
Yes.
So I thought, what can I do? So I started selling mabuyu. So I had a friend from campus who used to bring me mabuyu, and then, of course, at a price, and then sell them. But before I started selling the mabuyu, I had some money I had saved.
Yes.
So I started with a capital of 500. So 500 is quite a good number. And you see the mabuyu, you're not just getting them from anywhere. You're bringing them from Marikiti in Kos. The best of the best.
Yes.
So you hike the price kidogo. then I was able to get money to, you know, start selling gorillas, because I know there's a time it was too hot.
Yes.
So that is when I started, I got an idea to start selling deras, because I had bought one and everyone in campus was like, where did you get that? I was like, you people don't know me. I started a business niche.
Yes.
And that's how I started. Mm-hmm. So it's just from the savings that I had, they were not so much. So after I started the Mabuyu business, I was able to get some money to start the dera business. So I did the dera business alongside the Mabuyu. So I was getting money from two businesses,
yes,
from two items. Then Polepole, I was able to grow Polepole. And you know, when you have two businesses, when this one is not bringing you money, the other one is.
Yes.
So Polepole too. And then I have very good communication. I can convince you to buy something.
I can say that. You're already convincing me.
I can convince you to buy something. I mean, sir.
And you think that's very important for your business as well.
It is very important. Yes. Your relationship with people matters a lot. Imagine if I come to you and I can't, you're not even impressed. You know, with my first, you know, the impression, like, oh my God, she looks like a nice person. I will not even be able to tell you, I sell this and this. You'll be like, in the first place, I don't like your attitude.
Yes.
So I have just to come and, you know, that nice appearance and that first whatever has to matter.
Pretty much, isn't it? Why don't you talk to me about marketing, therefore? Because I consider you have very beautiful models who actually now make your outfits stand out. What is the relationship that you have with marketing, and especially in line with the models? And I want you to attach this, therefore, to a marketing strategy that we've seen most of outfits entrepreneurs actually use, is you got to have these models who are going to represent you. Is that a must for your line of business?
When I began this, I was my own model.
Yes.
Because I wore my pieces. So if it's the dera, how did they know I'm selling dera? I had it on.
Yes.
Then they asked, where did you get it from? And when 3-4 people asked, I was like, I sell it. I sell them. You see? So having, you see, this is not like a construction. It's not like a building. Wow. It's very easy to wear something that you sell. For example, it's very easy to wear my head wrap on.
Yes.
It's very easy to wear my outfit on. So that was the easiest part of my business, because I didn't have to hire models and pay models to do it for me, because I had just to put it on myself.
Yes.
So after some time is when I was like, oh, now there's some outfits that plus size women would like to put on. And they feel like if I'm wearing it on, I don't look very nice in it. So that's how I had to now start doing photo shoots and getting plus size women and this size women and this height women.
Yes.
Yeah. So models are very important in a business for the fashion industry. And that's why we have fashion shows, so that people can walk in your outfit for people to see.
Yes.
Because it's more convincing when someone isn't in an outfit,
yes,
compared to if it's just in on a hanger somewhere.
Yes.
So models really have come in handy for my business.
Yes.
Yeah.
And that is something that you've actually used. When did you start using models, therefore?
Even before I started getting models, I started doing my own photo shoots.
I see.
So in a head wrap,
yes,
and say available.
Yes.
In an outfit, say it's available.
Yes.
So when I had to get different variety of women, mm-hmm, is when now I started bringing in women. That was around 2017.
Yes.
End of 2017, because that is when I had a variety of clients.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah.
Talk to me, therefore, about exactly how your journey has been, because I do know it's not been an easy one. It's not like, boom, we started. And when you really went into this business, what would you say was that unique challenge, therefore, that you got into and said, wow, I did not expect this?
Actually, I didn't realize that I would transform my passion or my fashion for head wraps,
yes,
into a business. Because,
yes,
when I joined campus, people would say, you just joined campus. This is not Chama Wa Mama. I mean, yeah, it wasn't nice. I got such, you are in the wrong audience.
Yes.
You're just supposed to let the hair out, but you, on the other hand, has a head wrap on in something very,
yeah,
long. So for that, for me, that was something very unique. And later, that is when people were interested. Hey, and how did you do that?
Yes.
And where can I get that? And that's when I started making money from that,
mm-hmm,
the head wrap business. That is how I started it. So the main challenge was capital. You see, when you don't have capital, you can have ideas, but if you don't have capital, you can never start. And as I said earlier, savings for me really helped me. Because imagine I was very young. If I went to a bank and I want a loan, they would not give me.
Yes.
So the capital challenge is, I think, the most.
Yes.
How would I put it? It's the most common.
Yes.
For most people, because even when you were young, you want to start something, you just have the idea, mm-hmm. but you don't have the money. So it can, lack of capital can actually just put you down.
Yes.
Yeah, but most of it, the other challenge I got is, recently I just opened a shop. I was having a problem getting a shop because most shops in Nairobi, you need to pay goodwill, you need to pay I don't know how many months rent. And when you're a startup business person, it's very difficult.
Yes.
So most people have not started because in fashion industry, most people have not started because they don't have pesa ya goodwill, because you'll hear goodwill is 100,000, goodwill is 3 million and...
You don't have that money.
Have
is
that
because
money.
That's the money that you need to plow back into
yes.
business.
And
yes.
then there's mm-hmm. another... there's a myth, head wraps is only for women, and head wraps is only for old women. Old women
yes.
only are the ones who are supposed to wear head wraps.
Yes.
And then Ankara, Kenya uniform.
Ah,
and then some people are so scared.
Yes.
They say tailors always lie to us, kuja kesho, kuja kesho. So that is another problem. You have to, I don't know how people convince their clients, but you can approach someone and tell them, oh, I do this, that they'll be like, oh, mina joma fundi. So you might, if you cannot convince that client, you will lose them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So majorly, I think those are the main challenges that I
had. You actually confessing
yes,
them.
Yes.
I'll come to back to you and talk to you exactly how you've been able, therefore, to go through this and the experience that you've gained through the years that you've been in business. Just want to go back exactly to models again.
Mm-hmm.
So we can start talking about, for somebody who's watching them right now and going, to, wow, they look so beautiful. I want to look like that this morning. Let's start with the first model. How much is it going to cost me to do that this morning? And how long is it going to cost me to get it from Afrikiseri if I need it today? Let's start with the first one.
So for Mwanamkasi's outfit, the kimono, if number one,
yes.
I'll charge it for 5,000.
Mm-hmm.
And it should be ready... After someone places their deposit,
yes.
it should be ready in 2 days.
2 days?
Yes.
Isn't it? Let's talk about money, therefore, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
How much is going to cost me to dress like this?
So her head wrap is 1,500.
Yes.
Then the kimono is 5,000.
Uh-huh.
That is 6,500.
That is 6,500,
yes.
isn't it? But do I have to, because I see exactly how it is, do I have to also get something... I can see her shoes as well. Do I have to match it like that as well?
No.
Is that a recommendation?
No, because
yes.
for the shoes, mm-hmm. you can, this outfit, you can wear it with heels.
Uh-huh.
You can wear it in flat sandals. You can
yes.
wear it in, actually, it's a rubbers. Rubber
yes.
shoes, you can just rock it.
Yes.
So you don't have to, that's why I'm not, and then I don't sell the shoes, so that's why I'm not talking about
fantastic,
the shoe part.
Isn't
yes.
it? Yes, but she looks comfortable in that, and
very.
You can actually put it on like that, isn't
yes,
it?
Yes.
Pretty much. Let's go on to the African queen over the other side, isn't it? How much is going to cost me to dress like that?
So her dress would go for 8,500,
yes. mm-hmm.
and then her head wrap is going for 1,500.
Yes.
So that's 9,500.
Oh, fantastic, isn't it? And she looks lovely in
Thank
that as
you.
Well, isn't it?
Thank
ah,
you.
Good. All right. So you would say that is within what your target customer really wants to look like, isn't
yes.
it?
Yes.
All right. Fantastic. I know you went through those challenges. So somebody is looking at you and saying, "Wow, I want to be like Maren right there." What has experience taught you over this years that you've been in business throughout this time?
There's something about whatever someone believes in, God, Allah, nature, whatever.
Yes.
When you have something in your mind, when you have an idea, just go for it and start. Whenever you start, there's always, nature always just helps you. No matter how small, no matter kama progress ni hivi.
Start on
just
it.
Just start.
Yes.
Just start. You see, I did not know I would, who on earth thought we would sell head wraps? Seriously, who thought we would sell head wraps? But I just decided to start and boom, they know me as the queen of head wraps. Because
fantastic.
I decided to start.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
I will start with whatever I have, wherever
yes.
I am.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that's how it is. Just start and boom.
Let nature take course,
yes.
isn't it? All right, believe in the process. Good. It is International Women's Day on a Sunday. We've started celebrating them today.
Oh, amazing.
A lot of women are watching you right now and thinking, well, that's a good example. What final message could you have to that lady, that girl watching you right now and thinking, do I have space in a business as a woman in Kenya?
Oh, wow, yeah. There's so many niches, so many. You can make mats, you can make outfits. And the fashion industry, mm-hmm. I'll tell the truth.
Yes.
The fashion industry is a big cake.
Mm-hmm.
Even the designers that were there right now,
yes.
we can't even just finish the whole cake.
Mm-hmm.
So there's so many businesses people can engage in.
Yes.
There's so many things we can do to just empower mm-hmm. ourselves.
Yes.
So if you have an idea, go for it.
Fantastic, isn't yeah. it? I'm getting informed that one of my co-hosts, Stephanie Waso,
mm-hmm.
A social media analyst, she's just interested in actually getting that look.
Ah.
Right, and especially the head wrap look as well.
Uh-huh.
So now, just to cap this conversation this morning, we're going to end the show at that point. Can't we have Stephanie Waso sort of transition there for and get that head wrap look there for that we're talking about and
yeah.
see exactly how she looks this morning, isn't it? All right,
fantastic.
Stephanie Waso, so you are the model just coming, standing between our two models, isn't it? That's going to be a very nice picture. So you can actually move to where Stephanie Waso
okay.
is, and then we get to see exactly how the head wrap is going on. Fantastic. Good. All right, can we have a look at that? Where is the head wrap? You can actually sit, and then we see exactly where it goes. Ah, fantastic.
So Manan Kasi mm-hmm. can just move a bit.
All right, fantastic. All right. Mm-hmm.
So,
should I?
Yes.
Let's see. Yes, please. So this is a chiffon piece.
Wait, is it called a chiffon?
Yeah, it's a chiffon.
Maureen, I've never understood
fabric.
What is a chiffon. I hear ladies say that, but I've never really known what a chiffon is.
This is a cosmopolitan fabric,
yes.
which is very light.
Uh-huh.
So there's different types. There's
yes.
thick chiffon, there's soft chiffon,
yes.
there's soft cotton chiffon.
I see that.
So there's the cheapest and then there's the most expensive.
Mm-hmm. So this is the most expensive, I would like to think.
You see, it has a pattern,
oh,
so
I see that.
Of course it is.
Isn't it? All right.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
So first things, Stephanie Waso can actually put on her head wrap and come to the studio?
Yeah, of course. Oh,
is
my God. I love her face.
Yes. Stephanie Waso, she loves your face. So, so that is something that you can actually put on as a formal look, isn't it?
Yes.
Ah, fantastic. Good. All right. So what are we doing with the hair now?
So I'm just trying to put it in place.
Yes.
Because already I have something in mind.
Yes.
Because you see, before you do a head wrap.
Yes.
Miss Idea, my dear.
Ah, fantastic.
Before you do a head wrap.
Yes.
There's their face.
Mm-hmm.
There's the type of hair they have.
Yes.
Then there's the fabric
mm-hmm.
that you have, the type
yes.
of fabric you have, the length and the width.
And also, the location. So this is an
yes. Ah, fantastic. Good. Oh, Stephanie Waso, you're transforming. I can see that. Yeah. So I asked you this question, Marianne, even as we do that, are there head wraps for men?
Oh, yes.
Wait a minute. There are there.
Oh, yes, there are. But when the time we did them.
Yeah.
It was.
What is the reception around men having head wraps as well?
Kesari, you need to stop doing that. And I'm like, wait, don't tell me to stop it. But Muslim men wear that car.
Yeah, they do, don't they?
Higher. Aparinas, yes. they have their head wrap.
Yes.
Indians
have their head. So don't tell me, oh, it's
that you
I'm supporting gazing. They're like, Kesari, you're supporting gazing. And you need to stop. Yeah, you need to stop.
Yeah.
Did your mother teach you that? And I was like, oh, my mother, don't bring my mother into this.
Yes.
This is just fashion.
Ah, fantastic.
So
I like
you
how you have answers for that.
Yeah,
isn't
I'm also
yes.
just trying to make money. I mean,
ah, great.
Yeah.
I see that. Oh, she's transforming into an African woman.
This is
woman
her wrap.
Good. It has to go. What do we wrap our ears? What is the essence of that?
At times, okay,
yeah.
I love wrapping my ears.
Yes.
How I think she's comfortable.
Yes.
And you see, I didn't wrap all of it like I have done mine,
now.
So you can
yes.
see her wraps.
You can see the nice. Earring around
so,
my sport.
Do you know what the name of this wrap is called?
No, I don't.
It's called a Jewish.
Jewish?
No, it's a royal Jew. Like because this is Jewish. You know those royals, those queens?
Yes.
They used to wear this.
Uh-huh.
So, but I came to realize that this is a look that anyone can wear.
Yes.
For any, you know, like any location, any place,
mm-hmm.
any occasion. You can go to work in this. You can meet your boyfriend.
Yes.
you can go see Mama for Rurashio.
Yes.
You can visit her in this, I mean.
Oh, fantastic. So, Marine, while you're there, that's a very nice picture, actually.
Oh, here.
It's a very nice picture. look at that.
Thank you.
Beautiful women in the studio. I don't know why we came with this chair, because
yeah,
All right, let's just cut this conversation like this, therefore, if we enjoy that picture over the other side. Talk to me about how you've been able, because I want to get your final picture, therefore, on exactly where AfriKisser is going.
Mm-hmm.
What are you investing in currently? So paint for me the final picture of AfriKisser.
So right now, I really got a shop, which has been a dream for some time. It's 3 months old. Two months old. Yeah,
oh,
yes. Because we opened in January.
Yes.
We were at Deepak Towers on 16th floor.
Yes.
So my, let's not go to 5 years, let's go to 4 years.
Let's go to 4 years.
In 4 years, I'm very proud of Vivo.
Yes.
And I would like to just have stores like hers, you know, when you go to Sarit, AfriKisser. When you go to Rivers,
yes.
AfriKisser.
Yes.
And maybe in 8 years, we'll have, you know, like a whole floor. Just AfriKisser outfits for kids, outfits for mothers, outfits for, you know, everyone.
Yes.
Then I'm really, really hoping that my initiative for the cancer, women with cancer,
yes,
would be, you know, like, if you mention something about head wraps,
yes,
someone can pin it too. You know, Kisser does that. And people can actually come in and help, you know, help get more head wraps.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, because I noticed that hair is very important to a woman.
Yes.
And that's why even when someone is just shaving their hair, they at times not all the hair, because we have some women who just rock short hair, because hair is very important. When you listen to stories that are given by these women, they're like, when they're told that their hair will start falling off, it breaks them down.
Pretty much, isn't it?
So human hair and weaves are good. But when the hair is not there, when there's no hair completely, so it's not even very comfortable. When it's too hot, they have, but a head wrap is super comfortable. Mm-hmm. So the head wrap really comes in handy. So I hope maybe in 3 years, I'll just have a store with a lot of head wraps for those women, because
fantastic.
I love them very much.
Fantastic. Well, thank you very much for joining us on Business AM today. You've been part and parcel of our celebration this week, therefore, isn't it? Now, for those people who are actually interested in these products, you do know exactly what to do. You can pretty much look for AfriKisser, isn't it? I would like to thank you on social media as well.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Just type in AfriKisser, and then after that, you'll be pretty much looking good. All right. Now, I do know, we're going to sell this picture just before we end. So from here on Business AM, we're going to enjoy the shots, therefore, of exactly what we have prepared for you today. I'll just walk out, and then I don't know which is going to direct the shots of these models that we have in the studio today. For me, as I leave you with this one, thank you very much. I feel odd. I don't have my head wrapped, so let me just run out. All right, from Business AM, we wish you a very, very, very happy International Women's Day. Richie. That's them.